Good on you. Thanks, Tim, and thanks everyone for joining. Appreciate the opportunity here. I'm dialing in from San Diego, where our team is based, and quick summary of sort of what we are and who we are is we're the international rights holder for the Hydralyte brand, and we operate primarily in the U.S. and Canadian market. Many Aussies familiar with Hydralyte as a low sugar, high electrolyte mix, and that mix, when it hits your stomach, it's able to be absorbed immediately into your bloodstream, and it's universally adopted by the medical community. That's why it's found in every pharmacy in the country, and it's recommended by doctors for what we call clinical hydration conditions. So that's your cold and flu, your heat stroke, your gastro, the less kind of exciting aspects of dehydration. Consumers really embrace Hydralyte, though, for other things as well as clinical conditions, primarily travel, also sport, and famously hangovers. Hydralyte is pretty much Australia's most famous hangover cure, and drinking alcohol is an accelerator of dehydration, which is why you often experience dehydration symptoms the morning after. And so that's why Hydralyte works. It's clinically proven. It's science. It's 30 years old, and that's, you know, that's why it's got this wonderful mix of being doctor approved but embraced for consumers for everyday life. So that's us as a summary. Next slide, please. So brief kind of history on the company. I mentioned we're the international license holder. The Aussie business grew to be a dominant brand in almost a single brand category. The company sold for roughly $80 million. In 2014, they put the whole business up for sale, but prestige brands came in and said, "Oh, we're only interested in the Australian and New Zealand rights. We don't want to buy the whole company. You guys take a crack at the rest of the world." And so the company sold to them, but largely it was just the rights to, as I said, Australia, New Zealand, and then they took Middle East and Southeast Asia a couple of years later. So the company. The international company had a small distribution in Canada at that time. We've since become a national brand in Canada. We're the number two brand there after the market leader in both the US and in Canada, which is Pedialyte, a brand marketed towards kids. So we've been listed for about a year now, and we've continued to deliver on all of our milestones. So next slide, please. So these are some smiling faces of our board advisors and management. So that's me on the left. A lot of the investment that's come in over the last few years have been underpinned by the Swiss Wellness Group. Many of you in the investment community probably heard about Swiss Wellness when it sold. It was the largest consumer goods acquisition in Australian history. It sold for $1.7 billion. When Chinese group Biostime purchased the company. So George Livery, Adem Karafili, ex-Swiss executives, and Radek Sali, who was the ex-Swiss CEO, is the second largest shareholder after Dan O'Brien, the Hydralyte founder. And the rest of the group are a mix of e-commerce and in-market American-based expertise in consumer goods. So we have a wonderful supportive team around our management group. Next slide, please. So what I've noticed unique about the small cap space is, you know, a lot of investment comes into the businesses with largely no revenue, and it's betting on a future outcome. But Hydralyte is an established business. It's been operating internationally now for seven or eight years in Canada and about 5 or 6 years in America. The strategy we put in place back in 2018 when I became CEO is well underway, and we've been able to supercharge growth in the company. So we have an established national brand in Canada and a fast-growing regional brand in the US. Our gross margin tipped over 50% for the first time this year. And from a product innovation point of view, the best-selling products that we have in the whole company are ones that we didn't bring from Australia. They've been specifically formulated and launched to meet the needs of the North American consumer. We have a focus on e-commerce that's underpinned a lot of our growth, predominantly Amazon, which makes up approximately half our sales in the US and allows us to kind of bet small and then grow quick when we see things working. And as I mentioned, we're the number two brand in Canada, number two position, holding almost a fifth of the market up there, which which is in explosive growth at the moment. So next slide, please. So we talked about retail sales exploding. Shay Mitchell is an important part of the mix. We've started a partnership with her early in the year. She's a superstar in the influencer world. She has approximately 35 million followers, which, to give some context, the most famous Australian influencers have less than a million. And so we're talking 35 times the size of the most famous Australian influencers. Tom Brady is an example who most Aussies know, has approximately 12 million. So we're talking three times the size of Tom Brady in terms of scale. So our marketing investment is doubling next year, and talked about our dominance in the Canadian market already. So next slide, please. This is that point about the Canadian market. Approximately this year it grew to 33 million from 16 million. So it basically doubled last year in Canada alone. So forgetting America. And so that was underpinned by growth in our brand and in Pedialyte, the two market leaders. Interestingly, the American rapid rehydration business is worth $1.5 billion. And it normally normalizes to about 10 times the size of the Canadian market. What's been interesting is there was a regulation change in Canada 2 years ago, and that's underpinning this super growth. The regulation change is you couldn't sell hydration products online, and you could only sell them in the pharmacy section of the pharmacy. So that super growth will normalize to what will normally be a 10x the size of the US market, which, if that was right now, it would be $150 million. So there's gigantic tailwinds behind our Canadian business. Even if we didn't go to work for 3 years, the market would explode to normalize somewhere at 10 to 1. Next slide, please. So these are some of our recent sales highlights. On the right-hand side are our two biggest customers. I might skip to the next slide because it's clear and we'll run out of time. So next slide, please. Right-hand side is our trailing 12-month revenue in US dollars. So this is the mighty US dollar, which is a nice time to brag about making sales in US dollars. Our trading trailing 12 months, which you probably can't read, is 8.5 million. Although, as you can see, it's going up and to the right. In October 2022, we booked $925,000 in US revenue, which even that annualized is 11 and a bit million. But growth, you know, and that was outside of our peak months. So we tend to peak in the summertime when the weather's warm, but we had a record October, largely due to new product innovation. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So this is actually our year-on-year in Canada, which is a nice chart. You can see the black line is this year, the orange line is last year. There was an enormous heat wave in Canada around this time last year. All the Hydralytes sold out across the country as they were telling people on the news to buy a Hydralyte. What's been pretty exciting since is, you know, we've been able to maintain that growth, and we beat the heat wave peak of last year this year and continued that momentum out of summer. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So these are some of the new products we've launched recently. On the left-hand side is one dedicated to hangover reduction. It's a liver support. It's got milk thistle, prickly pear, and turmeric. We launched that on the 5th of July. It now does 1,000 a day. It actually does far more than that now. But when this deck was written, it was only 1,000 a day. We've launched tubs and new tablet flavors in Canada, and this Shay Mitchell collaborative SKU that we have actually launches next Wednesday. Next slide, please. So this is the collaborative flavor we're doing with Shay Mitchell. As I mentioned, she's one of the most powerful influencers in the whole of America. She was the third most followed woman on the planet this year. Third most followed pregnant woman on the planet this year. So she's anchored in family consumption. We partnered with her because she has a tequila brand that supports hangovers. She has a luggage travel brand called Base that does over 50 million in sales, which supports travel dehydration. And then she's a working out busy mom. And so that's why we got together with her. She's also Canadian. So that the Canadian factor gives us an outsized presence in the Canadian market, where approximately one in eight Canadian women follow her. So pretty crazy influence. And we have, if you go to the next slide, we have a launch event with her planned in Florida. It's actually in Miami in 5 days. So it's next Tuesday. We have 25 of the biggest influencers in America flying in for a 2-day event. Where we're calling it a hydration day out for all the mums of America. The cumulative following of the people attending this event is over 200 million. So to give you a bit of an indication, approximately 70 million watch the Super Bowl. So we're talking 3 times the Super Bowl eyes on this product next Wednesday. Next slide, please. So that's kind of where we've been. We're sort of in a pre-Shea world, and we're about to go to a post-Shea world next week. So that's been the focus of a lot of our marketing efforts, and we're excited that we've been able to supercharge growth without her, without this product, which launches next week. So that's probably it. If we go to the next slide, I think that's a great segue into some questions, if anyone has any.
Yeah, we've got several. Thanks, Oliver. Just one question. And when you're talking about Shay, there's a couple of observations she's been a bit quiet on in regards to posts. We've got people who've been following her since your last presentation. Is that because you got this launch coming up?
Yeah, it is. It is. She was actually, to be honest, away in October shooting a film. And so what we've actually scheduled the plan to be sort of post Black Friday. And we're in, if any of you guys know, we're in the period of the Boxing Day style sales at the moment, and it's very sort of shouty and focused on deals. So she's quiet for a couple of weeks, and then she'll ramp up from Tuesday next week. So if you follow her, you'll see a fair bit of action next week.
There's a couple of followers online. And what's the big plan in terms of big picture from marketing? You know, mainly when I think of hydration, I think of Gatorade. It's associated with sports people. Is that where potentially you want to get to, given notwithstanding budgets and those sort of constraints as well?
Yeah. Look, the it's funny. I took about a 1.5, 1.6 billion hydration drinks category. But that's just in the kind of rapid rehydration space, including clinical, including kind of lifestyle consumption, functional beverage and sports drinks, which is sitting over the top. There's another 100 billion of those out there. There's a mega, you know, category sitting over the top of this that this is growing in. So you can feel like 1.6 billion is a big number that you want to. When I worked at Swiss, 1.6 is the, you know, literally the entire. So that's just our space. And then what's happening are the Gatorades. People recognize that they're you know, filled with sugar, you know, and got no electrolytes in them. So as consumers get more educated, that's what's driving the uptick. Looks like my internet's a bit choppy, is it?
Yeah, we just turned off your camera, but we can hear you now. So in that regard, is the focus still on kind of e-commerce sales rather than face-to-face? Is there a product that could one day sit in the fridge and people could buy it?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's funny, in stores in America, the ready-to-drinks are still the dominant format because people just want to grab something ready to go. They're buying it from a pharmacy or a grocery store. And so it is those ready drinks that are the convenience go-to factor. I mean, you think about it, if you go to the 7-Eleven and buy yourself a drink, you know, you're not going to buy water and then a drink mix from the other aisle. So there's no doubt that the ready drinks sell more. Funnily enough, in Canada, it's 50-50 in stores. And so, you know, we're in every pharmacy in the country up there, and we sell a really nice mix of both liquids and powders, but consumers recognize the powders as being more convenient, more affordable per serve, far more sustainable because you're not shipping liquids around. And for us, that's higher margin as well. So it's win for consumer and win for the company. So we like consumers shifting into these drink mix formats.
And just finally, where's the focus in the US now?
focus is a combination of Amazon and store expansion. Amazon remains our largest customer. We do about $250,000 a month there. A fifth of our revenue is subscribed, which is pretty powerful, that one in five people are sticking with the product and they want it delivered to their door every 30 or 60 days. So that's nice kind of sticky revenue going forward. So we're continually focusing on building our subscriptions and launching subscribable products, right pack size, right flavor mix, things that a whole family can consume. Store expansion. We recently expanded into Publix, the supermarket. Publix is the largest supermarket in the Southeast. Probably no one's ever heard of them, but anchored between, Atlanta down to Florida. They've got only 1,000 stores and about $20,000 in retail sales through to them just in those ready-to-drink liquids. So that's, it's more kind of pockets of regional store rollout in America where our product has resonance, because America's a big place. You only need to be successful in a couple of states. We all know California is, sixth biggest economy in the world or something these days, six or seven. So there's plenty of wood to chop in only a few states.
Thanks, Oliver. That's all we have time for. It's a great story. And we've obviously had plenty of shareholders and investors online following that story since you last appeared on Hidden Gems. So thanks for your time. Have a nice weekend.
Likewise. Thanks for having us. And thanks for tuning everyone, and have a good one. See you.